Recording in progress.
Monitoring of cases upon request from the police department, and they also provide a coordinated community policing response with access to a variety of agencies to deal with severe personal and family problems signaled by recurring calls to the police department. What we have definitely found is with the needs in the city of Reading, if we could have two full-time civilian social workers employed by the city, that would definitely help with interactions between members of the police department and the public who are potentially experiencing mental health, addiction, and crisis-related issues. Program would help community members get access to programs and potential treatment options available to them. This program would be geared to help city residents who don't need police assistance but need assistance being connected to resources. Number of calls for service that police officers are currently responding to that are not criminal or police related in nature. And obviously these type of calls cause officers not to be able to respond to legitimate police calls for service, increasing officer response time. And then the second position that we will be looking for is potentially a full-time police technology specialist. We would like to have a dedicated person to help administer software and hardware needs specific to the police department, in that they would work hand in hand with the city IT department to be able to increase the functionality and efficiency of our department. 20 years ago, we did not have to rely as much on technology information, but now everything is online, everything's computer related, everything's software related, and when those programs go down, that causes potential issues with our officers being able to efficiently do their job. Currently, there are two IT people who respond to tickets and things like that for the entire city of Reading. And being that we are a critically necessary entity for the city with public safety, we need to make sure that our downtime is extremely limited, and having to potentially wait for one of the city IT people to be able to respond to our needs can sometimes cause unnecessary delay, with officers having to wait around here at City Hall before they can get back out on the street because their equipment's not functioning properly. The sworn positional changes that we're looking for are, we're looking for an officer to be assigned out at our range on a full-time basis to work as a range master and an assistant academy director. What that entails is, I'm assuming everybody knows, but in case you don't, the City of Reading runs their own police academy where we do training for officers and people who want to be police officers throughout the entire county. And we also have, because of our basically renownedness for our level of training that we put out, we have people sending their officers or potential officers to our academy from across the state at times. So having a range master there in a full time will allow us to, one, have some person, have someone assigned out of the range that they can be constantly updating and making sure that all of our firearms and such are serviced and functioning properly. Don't have to pull an officer off the street to repair a malfunctioning weapon. They also are out at the academy because we go and host a number of trainings, which brings in income for the city. We charge for outside agencies to come and use our firearms range, so that brings in income. And we need to have one of our employees out there whenever someone outside of our department is there for liability issues. We also like having someone out there too, because if our academy director is not available, then we have a sworn officer who is also out there with the cadets for their training out at the police academy. And then our other positional change for the services division is we would like to go and change our current quartermaster position, which is currently staffed by a sergeant, to a lieutenant position. based on what they're doing and their involvement with members of the administration, with purchasing, with finance and such, helping get contracts fulfilled and such, we feel that that position would probably be best suited by someone of higher rank. Up until the last chief, that position was actually held by a lieutenant prior. So we'd like to go and return that to a lieutenant position. It's currently staffed by a sergeant. We would like to also add 3 investigator positions to our criminal investigations division and add an extra officer to our evidence unit. With the increase of the electronic types of evidence, be it videos, our body cam videos, dealing with electronic devices and such, we currently have 3 major evidence techs and a sergeant dealing with all of that work right now. So we'd like to get a 4th one. And then, as I talked about, our 2 civilian social worker positions and 1 police technology specialist position. So the additional cost proposal for those positional changes for the services division, adding 1 officer position and promoting the sergeant to a lieutenant position would be approximately $130,000. The addition of 3 investigator positions and 1 officer position in the investigations budget would be $523,820 approximately. The addition of 2 full-time social worker positions to the admin division would be $185,500 to $235,500, depending on salary and experience. And adding 1 full-time police technology specialist position to the special services division would be approximately $83,000 to $98,000. All of the sworn positions, other than the pay increase from sergeant to lieutenant in services, is already factored into the budgets that have been provided to all of you today. So the only ones that would need to get added, and if you are on board for some or all of the civilian positions, then Mr. Kelly can get those added in tomorrow. Do you have any questions about any of those? Yes, sir.
Thank you for the very concise presentation. I guess part of my questions would be, while I certainly understand the need for all of the other positions, because I do, I think those social workers would be incredibly busy, and I really like that idea. But at the same time, I'm reluctant to move positions off of the frontline officers as well. I really don't want to lose any positions there.
The civilian positions would not take away from any sworn positions. No, two separate.
If I would like to almost to see some expansion there. I know we're having a difficult time filling positions, but I think we need more people on the streets as well.
When I originally did the budget, I had done it for upping our sworn numbers up to 175, which would have added an extra 7 officers. But due to the cost, I was told to cut out of the budget, and that's where I was told to cut from.
Okay. Because quite honestly, I'm sorry. Because quite honestly, I think I would love to add more people have more people on traffic. And those types of things. And while I certainly can appreciate the other positions, I especially like the social worker aspect. But in terms of department leadership, I just too many cooks and not enough people actually doing the cooking. If you know what I mean, that's kind of how I see it. That's my initial thought. Thank you.
Any other questions? Oh, Bill.
Just to clarify, this isn't going to be a reduction in the number of patrol officer positions that we have filled, right? We're probably around 150 some police officer position total in the city right now at a 168. So what the police department wants to do is make these changes to improve the efficiency of the patrol division also. So there's not so much downtime with the officers we have. And then if we can get up to our full allotment during 2024, it would be great. But with the number of resignations, retirements we have per year, we could actually, and that's what they plan to do if they possibly can, we can actually overhire and still stay within the budget, because as we onboard people, people are going to be leaving. So that's what we're trying to do, come as close as we can and keep to our full allotment and stay within the budget. We've done this once before years ago, and it worked out really good. So that's some of the things they're not talking about making the criminal investigator positions until they get more patrol officers on board. So there's not going to be a loss of people on the street.
Correct. We're just trying to look ahead for budgetary wise. So because we're going through the background phase for hiring for January right now. So we had 16 people that are going through the background phase to try to be able to hire them for January. So if we're able to hire the majority of those people, then that will bump us up to full complement. But we want to make sure that we're looking ahead and being fiscally responsible. So to be able to staff those extra positions that we're not coming to council further in the middle of the year saying, hey, we don't have enough money for these positions.
Go ahead.
I just have two statements, questions. One, I agree with Councillor Daubert about the social work positions. That's so critical. The only question I have is, would it make more sense to do a partnership with an organization that specifically already has a social worker program set up, as far as like training with up-to-date training, rather than to have it in-house?
It's not necessarily for the training, because our officers go through training on how to, for de-escalation, how to deal with people with special needs and alternative needs and such. This is more of a person who can go and connect the citizens or the clients with the resources that are needed versus a police officer having to do that and take time off the street.
Okay, I understand. Okay. And my second question is, I think we seem to keep hitting the same conversation. I know this came up the other night when we were talking about the budget, and that is the number of visible officers on the street. And I know in the past we've talked about the number of the force before we entered Act 47. And I know we've talked about the fact that the population has increased since then. Is there anything in place? And I understand that we just exited Act 47 and we have to be conservative. But is there anything in place, the same way when we talk about a comprehensive plan for the city, for the department, for planning for future police officers, that at some point the force will be up to the numbers that it was before we entered Act 47?
An official plan? No. But we are constantly trying to increase our numbers and going through trying to increase our recruiting ability, looking at alternative places to recruit. We're actually looking at putting in for a PCCD grant to see if we can get awarded for signing bonuses for hiring new officers. And we're also trying to get language together for a memorandum of understanding between the police department and the union to try and get in the ability to hire lateral transfers. So instead of a police officer who has experience for another department coming in at the trainee rate, to be able to bring them in at a higher rate for incentives to have them come to the city. So we're trying to do things like that.
Thank you.
I certainly appreciate your budgetary considerations here and being as fiscally responsible as possible. And so this really isn't so much for you guys as much as it's for us as a council body. But I absolutely believe that what they have described is necessary. I also think that it says something like where our priorities are. I know it's very difficult to fill those positions, but if we can add to them as well, I mean, I'm willing to do what is necessary in order to, because I think that's, we either have to do this and get it right or not. We can't halfway it. You know what I mean? I'm tired. It feels like the city halfways so many things. If we care about it and believe that safe streets are critical to pulling the city forward, we have to commit to it. And sometimes that can mean unpopular things, but ultimately, I don't see the city going to where I think it can be without those tough decisions made. So that's what I'm saying to my colleagues, really.
Go ahead, Wanda.
This doesn't pertain to the budget or anything like that, but being a resident here and adopting this city, my question is, which is all in total, how are we promoting the city in order to call in to police officers to come in and apply, being that the hiring or people not applying for it? How can we tell people out there, is that we need an outreach or some kind of career fair or something like that? We need to promote the city so we could promote the police department. So how can we go about that, and maybe we can help?
No, absolutely. We actually are in the planning stages of completing a couple of recruitment videos that we'll be able to put out on social media. So we're working with Noel from the city, and we had received money from PCCD to aid in recruitment process. Our community response coordinator, Lieutenant Lillis, is regularly going out to different colleges and different job fairs and such to tell what the benefits are for coming to the city. And Sergeant Fegley will be going into his position, and he'll be taking over doing the same thing. Mr. Daubert, to go on to your point, if we added the,
thank you,
sorry, ma'am, the 7 additional positions that I had taken out for patrol officers, that would add an additional 418,000 to the patrol salary.
Gonna tag on to Councilor Daubert. I think, and again, it's the conversation about the visible officers on the street. It's not just about the citizens, but the other thing that we're dealing with is the perception of the safety of the city. And as we talk about the revitalization of the downtown and the neighborhoods, this is a key component to making those things successful too. Until we start to see an increase in the number of visible officers, not just the ones that are there for serious crimes, which I'm not discounting, that's obviously very important too, but there is a definite perception, if you don't see police officers, you don't necessarily feel safe in the case of if you did. And I think that's one of the things we really need to start the conversation about. So I'm glad that, you know, we're talking about this tonight. It may not happen right away, but it has to be discussed and it has to be planned for if we're ever going to improve as a city.
No, absolutely, sir. And that's why I wanted to make sure that everyone had the most updated information and such as to what potential costs would be to get us up to that number.
The adding $418,000, that's actually far more realistic than I anticipated. It gives at least me something to shoot for as we're looking through this budget. in terms of, are there any areas that we can save some funds?
And that's just for salary. Obviously you have to add in benefits and such, which would throw an extra, I believe it's 30 or 36,000 per officer.
Oh, okay.
So it potentially would be about $1 million.
About $1 million. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, that was more in line. Because at first I was thinking, wait, are you serious? 418? We can probably find that.
Yeah, with additional 7 officers and approximately 36,000, that comes to approximately 220-ish, add plus the 400, that goes to the 600. So it may be closer to between 7 and $1 million, but top end for that. So, and if we didn't go for full 7 and went for maybe 5, that would potentially go and knock that down closer to maybe a number that is more reasonable.
I would obviously there's only 4 of us here right now, so we're missing 3, but this is something that I truly believe is in the best interest of the city and our residents. So it is something that I would like to work towards this budget. This is my last budget. I would like to see that happen in this budget cycle.
If you would like some updated numbers, adding 5, 7, et cetera, what it would increase the budget, I can provide that for council.
I would appreciate it. And I know that it would be it's going to be difficult to fill those positions, but I think it speaks to where our values are. And if things happen to change, we're never going to get to that number if we don't budget for
it. Correct.
So let's aim high in this case.
And remember, you don't have to fully fund those in the budget for an entire year, because you're going to be staggering the hiring and other people are going to be leaving. Yeah. So you could put kind of a cushion into the budget that they already have and start to try to over. You could put 175 officers in the position ordinance and allow the PD to try to get to that number as close as they can, but you won't have to fully fund all 7 of those officers.
Go ahead, Maria.
Thank you. Good evening. How many students do we have in the academy right now?
We have 4 that are in the academy right now. They will graduate in December and then come out on the streets in January.
We shouldn't patrol 15?
Yes. And those 4 that are in the academy are already accounted for in our 168 allotment.
And I know it has been a challenging for the police department to retain any new officer coming on board. And because I can see when they're leaving and stuff like that. So especially like this year, beginning of the year, some of they got in, 2-3 months later, they left the city. Any plan to retain those officers, the new officer coming on board?
I believe that there was an ordinance that had been approved by council prior for retention bonuses for officers that are here, but I do not believe that any funds were allocated for that line at this point. So if we were able to move forward with that, then that could potentially help with the retention along with the slowdown or the officers leaving have slowed down dramatically since our new contract came through with the raises and the benefits that some of the officers got back.
And mm-hmm. I mean, going back to what Councilman Chris just stated, I mean, we can budget for the manpower, but if we don't bring it over and we don't retain those officers, even we hire them, I mean, it's a fiasco, I would say. I mean, it's something that...
No, absolutely. And even the signing bonuses that we're trying to apply for, My thoughts would be not to go and say if you get $5,000 per new hire officer, don't give them that upfront. You give a little bit now, a little bit later, a little bit later as an incentive to stay with the department.
Yeah, I believe last year we hired like five and maybe two, maybe one or two stay out of the five, like the one that we hired like back in January. So yeah, it has been very challenging to retain new, and you know that. So thank you.
I also believe that as we get closer to a full, to being truly fully staffed, it may actually help us to retain officers if they were not stretched so thin. So that was one. And then two, I guess from a council position, I mean, we approved those bonuses, correct? So
I believe it was an ordinance that was approved, but no specific number or was put in it, just that yes, we approved doing this, but I don't think anything was ever put in any of the budget lines.
Okay.
I don't know if Maria can attest to that.
I we had to search. I don't remember from top of my head, but we can find out. I can find out. Thank you.
All right. Any more questions, comments? All right. Well, we thank you for presenting and doing it so quickly and efficiently. Believe that's all on the agenda. I just need a motion to adjourn. Oh, Wanda?
I have a comment.
Yep.
To all in all, you're doing a great job, especially your report.
Thank you.
Yep. All right. I just need a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
All right. We're adjourned.